Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we're gonna be diving into my October favorites. I love favorites videos. They are my favorite to watch and they are my favorite to film. I am so excited to be here right now. Like, I love talking about things I love. Like, it just brings me so much joy. I do have a few fails in this video, which I will talk about those later on in the video. I'm like kind of getting a little bit giddy because I'm so excited to talk about these products. Okay. As many of you guys know, I have been uploading a lot of content recently, and it's been a coping mechanism for me. In order for me to deal with sadness or anything, I have to stay busy, because if I am not busy, then all I will do is sit and cry, and I will just hunker down, stay in my room, shut the door, and just block out the world. And it's not a good place for me to be mentally. So, you know, I was already kind of struggling when my daughter left, and it was kind of just feeling really lonely around my home. And then having Mel pass away, it's been a rough month. So for me, I needed to dive in and just upload content. I needed to focus on my channel, focus on things that make me happy, focus on things that will keep my mind distracted from all of this sadness. It's been a great outlet for me. And during that time, I've tested out quite a bit of makeup over the last 30 days. So my favorite product that I have discovered is this. Oh my gosh. I am in love with this foundation, you guys. Absolutely in love. So I put this video up on September 26th. The day that I tested this, I've worn it every day since then. Now don't get me wrong, I don't wear makeup every day, but every time I'm wearing makeup, this is what I've been reaching for. I have foundations over there that I actually need to review, and I don't want to because I don't want to stop using this. I'm obsessed with this foundation. This is the Beauty Blender Always On Radiant Skin Tint, and it's in their Bounce line. It has rocked my world. The best skin tint I've ever tried in my life. For me, I get medium coverage. It lasts all day. It looks beautiful. It looks amazing over wrinkles, amazing over texture. It never gets thick and cakey and gross. And it acts like a foundation, but it's such a thin formula. It's almost got more of a watery texture to it. Now, in fact, I just got done filming my fall autumn makeup look, which is what I'm wearing right now. If you guys haven't seen that video, I will link it in the description box. But in that video, I talked about this formula being very similar to the Pat McGrath Sublime foundation. The difference is this has got more coverage than that one does from Pat McGrath. Plus, it's $29 and the Pat McGrath's like $68. But this one has more coverage, and I feel like it lasts longer on me than the Pat McGrath, and I'm obsessed with it. I recommend this for dry, normal combo skin. If you have oily skin, you might be able to wear this, but you would really have to have a good setting powder to kind of lock it down, because it does kind of give you that fresh look. But if you're okay with that and you have a really good setting powder, I think it might work for oily. I think I'm gonna say this. This is the best skin tint I have tried ever. And I have a lot of great skin tints, you guys. And who knew it would come from a company that creates sponges? Like, it's bonkers. Amazing. They knocked it out of the ballpark with this. I wear the shade Tan 2. It is beautiful. Fantastic. It's $29. Like, I'm obsessed with it. I can't stop reaching for it. I love the way it makes my skin look. And I also love that all throughout the day, my skin never changes. It's gorgeous. Hats off to them for creating that skin tint, because hot damn, it's good. Okay, let's move on to my other product that I'm obsessed with. You guys won't be surprised to hear. It is the new Cheeky Posh Blush Sticks from Victoria Beckham. Now, I reviewed these on my channel, and at that time I had two colors. I fell so hard in love with it that I bought two more. In the video, I had these two colors. This is Mini Skirt and this is Roller Skate. I loved them so much that I went ahead and bought Knickers and Playground. I think Playground and Miniskirt are kind of similar. Miniskirt's just a little bit darker, but they kind of have that same tone. I wouldn't recommend both, is my point. I love the formula on these for two reasons. Number one, they're not too pigmented to where you get too carried away and you put too much on, okay? So you can build it really easily, and I like to go directly, like push it up and then go in with a brush and go directly into it and apply it. Now you can go directly on the skin and blend it out, but I don't like to do that. I don't like to do that with any cream blush. I like to have control. I'm gonna go into the shade Knickers, okay? This is a new shade that I got. So I'll take my brush and I'll dip into it like this. And I will apply it like that. And I'm like, oh, okay, I need a little bit more here. And I'll just kind of build it and kind of keep tapping it in. The thing that I love the most about this formula is that it gives you that skin-like finish where it kind of gives you that shine, a little bit of that dewy look, but it doesn't make your foundation underneath transparent. There's a lot of cream formulas out on the market that if they have that like shine to it, it will make the foundation from underneath kind of become transparent. So all the hyperpigmentation, all of the junk that you just covered up with foundation kind of comes through, which is one of my biggest pet peeves with the cream formula. But this one gives you the skin-like finish. I mean, you can see the shine. They have the shine, but they also have like a velvety matte texture. So they're like a perfect mixture between the velvety matte and the shine. And it's this perfect balance. Fantastic formula. She killed it with these. Just a gorgeous, gorgeous product. Oh, she did a good job. Next up, we have these from Huda Beauty. So if you didn't want to spend that much money on cream blushes, or maybe you're just not into cream blushes, these are gorgeous. I particularly like this one. I think I'm going to buy the berry one. I don't know. I don't really need it, but I was thinking about buying the berry one during the Sephora sale. But this one is in the shade Caring Coral, and these are kind of that hybrid formula. So if you've ever felt the Natasha Denona, like the cream powder formula, the one that's the matte shadow, but it's that creamy texture, that's what these remind me of. So these are very, very forgiving and very easy to apply and just a gorgeous formula. Like, I really like these. And it's the exact same formula as the Glowish bronzers. So if you have those Glowish bronzers and you like it, you will love this formula. So I also picked up the shade Healthy Peach, and I actually wore this the other day when I didn't really have a lot of makeup on. I had the skin tint on. I didn't even put any mascara on it. I wanted to put a little bit of something on the face, but I didn't want like a bunch of makeup on, and this Healthy Peach was really beautiful. So it's just like that light wash, but these are really nice. The pans are small, but I don't really mind it because I have so many blushes that I don't need a big old thing of blush, right? So those are great, still loving them. Hats off to Huda for making those. All right, let's talk about this palette. I just recently uploaded my video of this palette. This is the Mini Metropolis. Ah, it's so beautiful. I don't reach for the regular Metropolis palette because it's like, there's too much of the cream to powder formula that I don't love and there's too much going on. This, I love, love this. And the thing that I love about the minis is it's like Natasha does all the work for you. Like, she pairs up tones that will work and they're just like foolproof. They're easy. You don't have to like think about it too much. Like, she brings the colors together for you and creates something like this. Plus they're much more affordable than the bigger ones. And this Mini Metropolis, it's so good. A little bit of an update on the Hermes highlighter. I have still been using this. I do really like this highlighter. Do I feel like it's worth that price tag? Absolutely not. I wish the packaging was better. I do feel like the highlighter stands out above some of my other formulas that I have, which it kind of, in my opinion, because the highlighter is a little more unique, it makes up for the janky packaging. So how I have been enjoying this is I will take my highlighter brush and I will bring it like right here, and it's so forgiving on pores. There's not a lot of highlighters that you can wear that don't really emphasize pores. This one doesn't. It like has this light reflection to it where it just looks really beautiful over the pores. And I can't say that I like it. At the end of the day, it is what it is. I've been really enjoying it. Yeah. Next up, I got to talk about this jewelry that I recently discovered. So I would say about 2 weeks ago, maybe, I was watching Morgan Turner, one of her videos. I don't remember which one it was, but she had mentioned that she had picked up a pair of earrings from a Instagram page. So I went to check it out and I found these gorgeous earrings. So this jewelry creator, she takes real Chanel buttons. They're refurbished, basically. So she takes the real buttons and she makes jewelry out of them. And it's a genius idea. I actually just bought 3 new earrings the other day because I'm just so excited. I love these earrings. These are the white quilted ones, and I'm obsessed with them. They are so beautiful. And these earrings are gorgeous, but I didn't have to pay the high price tag for a pair of Chanel earrings. So they're not fully real. They're not fake either. And that's the beauty of it. I also picked up this gorgeous necklace, and the chain is really good too. So that was the thing that I was worried about, you know, would the jewelry be good quality? And it absolutely is. All the two pieces that I've gotten so far, like this chain has the little clasp on it, really good clasp on it. And this chain is exceptional quality. Like you can tell that she didn't go cheap on anything, and I appreciate that. And this is another piece that I got that's a Chanel necklace, and I just love it. So I wanted to share that with you guys. I know that many of you have seen it. I will link her Instagram page and also her website in the description box down below. I'm excited to get the three new pieces that I just ordered the other day. I'm so excited. But she's a small business owner, and I love supporting small businesses. I mean, this is like the best of all worlds. You get to use something that's a real Chanel product without paying the crazy high price and also supporting a small business. I mean, it's kind of a no-brainer. And she's very sweet too, very, very sweet. So I definitely wanted to mention those. Okay, so the next products I wanted to talk about is the new products that I found for my skin that I am loving. Oh my gosh, I'm loving them because they're fragrance-free. This is from the brand Necessaire. I picked this up at Sephora. For me, these two are like the most magical together. So I first got the body serum, and it kind of has like a gel-like texture. This is hyaluronic acid for the skin, for the body. So it's hydrate, replenishes, and plumps. And so it has the hyaluronic acid in it, and it's fragrance-free, by the way. And I put that on, and I'm like, ooh, that feels good. And then when you go over it with the body lotion, it kind of locks the serum. It's a great combination. I mean, don't get me wrong, I'm still loving my Bay Harbor Beauty. I mean, Bay Harbor Beauty is like my ride or die. But I'm always looking for more lotions and more things to kind of play with and feel. And these two are fantastic. Obsessed. I also have this one for the hand. So I bought the hand cream. I have the small one in my purse, and then I have this one that I keep like at my kitchen. And this one is also fragrance-free, and I love the way that it makes my hands feel because it doesn't feel like oily or greasy. And because that's the thing about the body butter from Bay Harbor Beauty. I love it on my body, but I don't love it on my hands because it keeps my hands greasy. This one doesn't keep my hands greasy, and I love that it's fragrance-free, but I'd never tried the brand Necessaire. I'd never tried it. I'd seen it on Sephora, never tried it, and now I kind of regret it because it's a great brand. So I recently went ahead and picked up the body wash. I haven't used it yet. I just got it yesterday. I got it in the eucalyptus scent. Now you can get this one also fragrance-free. I think it has like sandalwood, eucalyptus, and fragrance-free if I'm not mistaken, but the eucalyptus just smelled so good, and I love the smell of eucalyptus, and I'm probably saying that wrong, but that's how I say it. But so I decided to go ahead and get that scent, but I have been so impressed with this. Even my husband, like he was, you know, saying, hey, could you put some lotion on my back? It's feeling a little dry. You know, he can't reach his back. So I went ahead and put on the serum first, which I think the serum is like a game changer. So here's the thing. If you didn't want to buy all of it, I would recommend the serum over everything. Like if there was one product out of all of the products that I just talked about between the hand cream, the lotion, and the, well, I haven't tried the body wash, but this one I feel like locks. Like it gives you that hyaluronic acid, like it gives you that moisture. And this, in my opinion, is like the game changer. It's a good, good product. So if you guys have been curious about Necessaire, I am quite impressed. I'm going to be honest. I'm quite impressed. Good product. So the next products I wanted to talk about is from Refer. So Refer recently released their holiday collection. I am loving these new brushes. In this bronzy makeup look, I was talking about this brush. This is the number 30. This is the best bronzer brush for the forehead. It doesn't give you the mushroom head. You know what I'm talking about, where it has that line across the forehead. It's so funny because you can always see bronzer, especially when people like turn on the camera, a lot of content creators, because the camera kind of points out all of the like weird stuff about your makeup. Like right now I got some redness right here, and so it's really coming out to play. This is a great bronzer brush for the forehead. I've never found a brush that works as good in the forehead as this one. It's a great brush. Of course, Reffer needed a foundation brush, and this one did not disappoint. They also needed a concealer brush, and this one did not disappoint. These three brushes, well done, Reffer. Now, with your purchase, you also get this little organizer, and I'm gonna try to do mine. It's magnetized. So these all come in separate pieces. I just kind of put mine together briefly, but they're magnetized, so they come apart like this. And they connect, and there's a big set of them. They also have these where you can put palettes and you can put them together, magnetize or separate them. I mean, Reffer did such a good job on these. I am so obsessed with them. I am still figuring out what I'm gonna do with mine. But like, look at these. Like, what a genius idea, because you can pretty much create whatever you want. So how many times have you bought a makeup organizer and you have to work around the makeup organizer because it's like weird and funky and you don't know like where you're gonna put stuff? This, you can put it any way you want to because it's all magnetized. It's fantastic. They did a great job on this. I am so proud of them for creating this. I love mine. And I'm still kind of putting mine together and kind of working and what I'm gonna leave out and what I'm gonna put away in my drawers and all of that. Well done, Reffer, well done. Let's move on to the next product. I wanna talk about a few products from Chantecaille. So Chantecaille was kind enough to reach out and send me some skincare, okay? I'm not on their PR list. They did give me a discount code, which was really nice of them, and they said it worked for makeup and skincare, so just FYI. I don't get anything from it, though. It's just for you guys to use. So they sent me 5 products. I have them here. 3 of them I love, 2 of them not so much. So the one that I don't love so much is the anti-pollution mattifying cream. Now, this does mattify. So for me, having dry, normal skin, mattifying cream doesn't really work for me. If you have oily skin, this will be amazing for you because it mattifies. Let me show you. When I mean, look at that. No shine. When I put this on and then went over with foundation, it was too mattifying for me. I was like, wait, where's my shine? I want my doingness back. But if you struggle with oily skin or even combo skin, meaning that, you know, if you have dry spots around here, but you're oily here, like this is a great cream. For me, it's a no-go, but it's a good cream. The other product they sent over was this lip potion, and I've had this for probably about a month, maybe a month and a half. I've had it for a while. I've been testing it out. This was all the way at the top. Now, I don't mind this, okay? But I think first of all, I think it's very overpriced for how much you get because you don't get very much. But number 2, I have nails. So sticking my finger down in here is impossible because my nail catches. And so the only way I can use it is I have to dig in there with my fingernail like this, which I hate doing. So I don't mind the formula. I'm not using it anymore because the packaging is too small. So it's cute, but it's just too small. Now, I would say my favorite product that they sent me out of the 5 is this one. This is the Blue Light Protection Hyaluronic Serum, and I really like this serum. And a little bit goes a really long way, so you can see that little drop right there. One drop goes all over the face, and that's the other thing that I like about this. I like that it doesn't have a fragrance, so it's fragrance-free, but I have been really enjoying having, because I've been doing, as many of you guys know, I uploaded a video of my Obagi skincare. I'm back on the Nuderm system and my skin is shedding like crazy. And because I'm exfoliating constantly, I need constant hydration. And this has really saved and helped my skin. I've always heard from friends of mine that love Chantecaille. They're like, you know, their makeup is hit and miss, but their skincare is unbelievable. And they're right. I'm very impressed with Chantecaille skincare. It's expensive. But these three products, I've been very impressed with. So I can see like why people like their skincare. In fact, I will definitely be repurchasing this one for sure. Now, the other product that I have here is the Jasmine and Lily Healing Mask. This is a mask, you can wear it as a mask or you can wear it overnight, like a night cream. And that's pretty much how I've been wearing it. I don't know if you can see how much I've used. I will go on with my Nu-Derm system and put it all over my skin. And then I will put this on after everything absorbed. Like I'll put on my nighttime Nu-Derm skincare routine and wait about 10 minutes and then I'll put this on. It's a great product. Now the one that I haven't used much of, and I'm gonna be honest with you, I've reached for this one more, which is the the healing mask, but they also sent the flower harmonizing cream over. I haven't used this one as much. Like I don't know if you can tell how much I've used. It's white, so it's kind of hard to see. I've used some, but I haven't used this one as much. So I think once I get through the healing mask, I will start using the harmonizing cream. But nice skincare. Like this is the first time I've ever used Shantikai skincare. And I can see why people really like it. They do have nice skincare. The thing that I liked about them is that they said, be honest. Talk about the products. Don't talk about it. We don't care. They were so... they were okay with me, like, because I told them, I was like, yeah, the mattifying cream just doesn't work for me because of this and this. And like, that's fine. Like, tell it. Like, we don't. And I like that. I like when a brand will send you PR and they're okay with you sharing products that you don't like, because a lot of brands don't like that. I'm just going to tell you from experience. A lot of brands will say, well, just don't talk about it then. Don't talk about the products that you don't like. Shantikai, no way. They said, you talk about what you like and what you don't like. You say whatever you need to say. So I appreciate that about Shantikai. Let's move on to the few fails that I got here. And we're going to first start with this palette from NARS. I had high hopes for this because this is a beautiful palette. The textures of these are beautiful. My biggest complaint with this is that all the shades look the same except for this one. These shades all look the same. I've tried them all. You can't tell I've tried them all. All the shades look the same. On my skin tone anyway. Now, I don't know how it's working for everybody else. I really haven't watched any reviews. But it's a very like creamy kind of formula. But they all look the same. All of them. I have tried so hard. I'm like, what is the deal? But they look the same. The only one that doesn't is the one, like the peachy one. So this one looks different. But like all of these look the same on my skin. And it's not worth the entire palette to have these shades look the same. Now it looks beautiful in the pan. The formula is amazing. So what I would hope NARS would do is just make this in the singles because it's a great formula. It's actually kind of similar to the Glow Wish. It has that like creamy powder texture. It's kind of a hybrid, but all the colors are the same for a blush palette. I just don't get it. And I don't like the color of the highlighter either because it's kind of purple, but the blush palette, the formula is gorgeous. I just don't like how all of the colors look the same on me. They just do. Now, I don't know if anybody else is having that experience. If you bought this palette, share with us in the comment section down below, you know, your skin color, like your skin tone, and how these shades look on you. Because on my medium to tan skin, they don't look that different, which is a bummer. It's an expensive palette to have them all look the same, you know? Okay, let's talk about this Naked Beauty, okay? This is called the Naked Pink Palette from Tom Ford. Wah, wah, wah. Like, really? I had a comment from somebody say, well, it's a naked palette. What do you expect? I hear you. I hear you. It is. It's a naked palette. I even said in my review that it's living up to its name, okay? But it's not only the fact that the colors are light where I have my issue. Where I have my issue is this palette is not worth the price because this is hard panned, this is hard panned, and this is hard panned. Now, when you spend $89 on a quad, you should not experience this junk, okay? That's number one. Number two, holidays are supposed to be special. If people want a naked palette, then put it in your regular collection. Don't make it a special holiday quad, and then it is hard panned junk, and you're trying to make it be this like amazing, come on now. I have a problem with it being the holiday quad because last year's was amazing. I have a problem with it hard panning, so the quality is crap, and it is so light, only a few people can use it, okay? So, yeah, I am still, as you can tell, I'm still pissed about that palette because this is junk. This is junk, you guys. Such junk. Okay, we're going to move on. The next thing I want to talk about is the Glow Wish. Now, my friend Gabe from Gabe Loves Makeup, he just uploaded his video and this looks gorgeous on him. This is the Glow Wish Luminous Pressed Powder. I tried this over the weekend, y'all, because I saw him put it on and I was like, gosh, it looks so good on his skin. And he and I wear pretty much the same shades and like foundations. And we like the same things. I think he likes products a little bit more shiny, a little bit more dewier than I do. But I was like, gosh, it looks beautiful on him. And if maybe I could try to make this work. You guys, this makes me look like the tin can and I can't do it. It's too much shimmer. So I've given up trying to make it work, but my friend Gabe loves it. And it does look gorgeous on his skin. So I do feel like this is going to be a powder that you're either going to love or you're going to hate. And I'm one that's like, it's a no-go for me. And it's a bummer because I think it has a great potential because I think if you can get it to work, it's stunning. But for me, it's a no-go. Finally, we're going to talk about this. Okay. This is a sweater that I got from Wooden Ships. Okay. Have you guys ever seen these sweaters on Instagram from this brand, Wooden Ships? Have you ever seen it? Right up here, you will see I spent $117 on this sweater. Y'all, here's the thing. The picture, it looks so cute. And I love those like really distressed kind of holy looking sweaters, but they have to be good quality. This thing, my dog touches me and it shreds. See this? This has all happened. I've got them all around my hand, right? I mean, yeah, it does give the distressed look. But like, it's bad quality. It's really thin material and it's like really thin kind of yarnish. And I don't know, I had higher hopes for this sweater and because I loved the way that it looked. And I also thought it would be a cute sweater to wear on the beach, like underneath a bikini or something. And you're just kind of, you know, chilling or whatever, but it's bad quality. In case any of you guys have seen the ad for this on your Instagram, take it from me, do not spend your money on it, you guys. It's way too much money for the quality. Plus, I really don't like the feeling of it. It's not soft at all. In my opinion, when you spend $117 on a sweater, it better feel amazing. Even if it's distressed, or even if it's the distressed type of texture, it needs to be soft. And this is like kind of crunchy and kind of, I just don't, like you can hear it. Yeah, I don't like it. I look at it like if it's showing up in my feed, it's probably showing up in your feed and I need to save you from buying this because it's bad quality. So that's it, you guys. That's the list. Those are my favorites and a few fails. Thank you guys so much for hanging out with me and supporting me and just being my community. I am so incredibly blessed. I hope you guys all have a wonderful day and I will see you guys all in my next video. Love you. Bye.